Good morning everyone. Today we are going to learn about hydraulic machines. Now when we consider the hydraulic machines, there are two important things which we have to concentrate on. First one is hydraulic turbines and second one is hydraulic pumps. So we'll start with the first half of this unit, that is related to hydraulic turbines. Now introduction. Now when we consider the term hydraulic turbine, it usually means that it is simply a machine which uses raw energy of any substance. Now when we consider the substance, in this case now we are going to correlate that or indicate that substance as the water in this case. Now when we consider the movement of that water into certain portion of that hydraulic turbine, then that is what we are going to learn in this particular unit. So we will simply read out the definition. It is a machine which uses the raw energy of that substance and converts it into mechanical energy. Now when we consider the hydraulic turbine as a combined word, we can see that hydraulic term, it is related to the water, the energy which is possessed by that flowing water. And when we consider the turbine, it is mainly dealt with the generation of power. So we have to take the use of these both things, and then whatever the energy which is produced or the power which is produced, it is called as the water power. Now what is the principle for turbine? Now that turbine is simply based on simple principle where an hydraulic energy of flowing water, it is getting converted into mechanical energy with the help of some arrangements. Further, that mechanical energy is again converted into electrical energy. So there are different parts or components by which we have to convert that hydraulic energy into mechanical energy and then mechanical energy into electrical energy. We are going to see that in later part. Now the mechanical energy developed by turbine is used to run the electric generator which is coupled to the shaft of turbine. So the shaft of turbine, the electric generator and the nozzle, these are the three important things which we have to consider while we are trying to learn about the principle of hydraulic turbine. Now the hydroelectric power which is generated by using this thing, it is the most cheapest source of the power generation. Now we have to concentrate on the types of hydraulic turbines, but before that we should just get an idea about the different parts of the turbine so that it will be helpful for us to understand the classification of that turbine. So now in this diagram I have just shown a schematic diagram for Pelton wheel turbine, which is one of the type of turbine. We are just seeing this image at this particular moment so as to just learn about the different parts, and those parts will be helpful for us to understand the classification of that particular turbines depending on the different types or different area. Now first, this vertical pipe, that pipe is called as the penstock. Through that pipe, water reaches to this particular portion which is called as the turbine house. Now when we consider the flow of water through this penstock, there at the entrance in this turbine house, it flows with certain water jet. Now when we consider that, or when we see in this diagram, there is certain arrangement which is provided at this inlet which is near the nozzle. It is called as the spear. Now when we consider this spear is used to adjust the flow of water so that we can change the flow of water into the turbine. This is quite usually done when there is variation in need of electrical energy. So with the variation in electrical energy, we can vary the flow of water inside the turbine also by using this spear. This spear is mounted on certain supports and which can be handled by using a hand wheel which is provided at this particular end. Now next part is this central portion. This is called as the runner. On this runner, the periphery of this runner, there are certain bucket like structures which are provided. They are also called as vanes. And in the center part of that runner, there is provision of shaft which is shown by this circle. Now when this jet strikes the blades, it starts rotating and the remaining or that all water falls in this particular region which is called as tail rest. So these are some of the parts which we have to consider, and if we know these parts, then it is easy to understand the different types of turbines or classification of turbine. So we'll try to learn that part. Now classification of turbine. There are different methods depending on which we can classify the hydraulic turbines, out of which first one is according to energy at inlet. Now when we consider energy in case of hydraulic turbines, we have to mainly concentrate on two things. First one is kinetic energy and second one is pressure energy. Now there is categorization in two different parts depending on these energies. First one is impulse turbine. So when kinetic energy is predominant at the inlet than the pressure energy, then that type of turbine falls under this category, which is nothing but impulse turbine. Example is Pelton wheel turbine, which we have already seen in previous diagram. Second one is reaction turbine. When pressure energy is predominant, then it falls under the category of reaction turbine. Francis turbine and Kaplan turbine, these are the two examples of reaction turbine. Second, according to the direction of flow through the runner. Now when we see that diagram again, I will try to explain these directions in that diagram. So let us consider this diagram again. This is the central part where there is shaft. Now if water flows perpendicular to this particular part, then that type of flow is called as axial flow. When water flows along the periphery of this runner, that type of flow is called as radial flow. And the flow which is shown in this diagram, where the water is flowing tangentially to the buckets or that runner, then it is called as tangential flow. So we can see the classification now according to direction of flow through runner. First one is tangential flow. Water flows along the tangent of the runner. Example is Pelton wheel turbine. Radial flow. When water flows along the radius through the runner, then that type of turbine is called as radial flow turbine. Now, when we consider in general, there is no radial flow turbine which we nowadays use. Third type is axial flow turbine. Water flows along the axis of rotation of runner. Example is Kaplan turbine. And fourth one is mixed flow turbine. Water at the inlet is in radial direction and it exits the turbine in axial direction. So it enters in radial direction and exits in axial direction. So example of that mixed flow turbine is Francis turbine. Now next, according to the head available at the inlet. Now we already know the concept of the head. So depending on the value of that head, again we can classify the turbine in three different types. First one is low head turbine. When head of water is less than 60 meters, that type of turbine falls under the category of low head turbine. Example is Kaplan turbine. Second one is medium head turbine. When head of the water is between 60 meters to 250 meters, then that type of turbine is called as medium head turbine. Example is Francis turbine. Third one is high head turbine. When head of the water is more than 250 meters, then that type of turbine is called as high head turbine. Example is Pelton wheel turbine. And last one, according to specific speed of turbine. Now we are going to learn the meaning of this term, specific speed, in latter part. But for time being, let us concentrate on different types according to that specific speed. First one is low specific speed turbine, where specific speed is less than 60. Example is Pelton wheel turbine. Second one is medium speed turbine, medium specific speed turbine, where specific speed lies between 60 to 300. Example is Francis turbine. And third one is high specific speed turbine, where specific speed is greater than 300. Example is Kaplan turbine. Now, next part is related to the hydroelectric power plant. So this is the schematic diagram of hydroelectric power plant. So this is very much important. Now in this diagram, we can see different names are given to different parts, and this is what we have to explain, how that hydroelectric power plant works. Now let us start with this left hand side. This is nothing but a dam. That means a body which is constructed across any river so as to store the water. The stored water is called as reservoir, or it is also called as head race. Now when we consider the downward or downstream part of that dam, there is provision of one pipe through the body of that dam, and that is called as the penstock. We have already seen the meaning of this penstock. Now through that penstock, water is going to enter into this turbine house, in which we can fit the different types of turbines so as to produce the electrical energy. Next one is surge tank and valve house. Now when we consider the valve house on this penstock, it is used to regulate the flow. That means when there is no need to produce the electrical energy, we have to just stop the flow of water so that turbines gets stopped. So in that case we have to close this valve. But when we try to close these valves, there is possibility of the effect, which is nothing but water hammer. We have already learned about that concept of water hammer. So what actually happens if we suddenly close that valve? Then there will be generation of pressure, and that pressure will be applied on side walls of this pipe. This pipe is usually made up of steel or reinforced concrete. So when that excessive pressure develops because of this sudden closure of the valve, there is possibility of bursting of this pipe. So to avoid that thing, we have to release the pressure, and to release the pressure, there is provision of this surge tank. So whenever there is closure of valve, the water rises in this portion and there is release of pressure. Or in sometimes the function of surge tank is to provide the additional water. That means when there is scarcity of water in this penstock, then the water from this surge tank is used so as to generate the electricity. This is the turbine house in which there will be provision of turbine, which we have already seen. We can provide any type of turbine as per the requirement. And the water body which is formed, and that downstream side, it is called as the tail race. Now in this diagram we can see the gross head. Now the gross head is the difference in head between head race and tail race. Consider this line at the bottom part. Then when we consider the net head is the now when we consider the gross head is the addition of net head and HF. HF stands for the loss of energy because of the friction. So when water flows from this part to this part, there will be certain loss of energy, which we are going to denote by HF. So we can calculate the gross head as it will be addition of net head and energy loss. So in this manner we can study the different components of hydroelectric power plant. Now the water is moved through this penstock, which we can regulate using valve house, and then it is moved into the turbine house, where a jet of water strikes the blades of that turbine or buckets of that turbine, which rotates the runner. Ultimately that runner is attached to the shaft of that turbine. The runner rotates that shaft, and that shaft is connected to the generator. Now using this thing we can generate the electricity, and we can use that energy for different purposes. So this is nothing but a hydroelectric power plant. There are certain definitions which are written here. The all definitions are explained in previous slide. Thank you.